please. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages. I'm Kirk Yeehee, and this is Chapter 3 of The Last Yandere. Let's jump into it, shall we? Oh my god, we're actually going to be locked in our basement, aren't we? And I see, like, a Minecraft torch there. Ha! That was literally the first thing that came to my mind. And this looks like sandstone from Minecraft. I may be playing a little too much on Minecraft lately. In any case, I wake up, unable to move. I couldn't remember where I was or how I got here. And then I remember the cake. No sooner had the words crossed my mind when I heard cars giggling. Great. You're awake. Took you long enough. I gotta remember the lesson and the dosage next time. Great, there's gonna be a next time? Great. What is this? If you think this is bondage, it isn't. We're not there yet. Wasn't at all what crossed my mind, but okay. I attempt to stand, but my wrists were stuck. I look down to notice my entire body tied down to a chair. I think that's something you probably notice pretty quick, quite honestly. I mean, I've never been tied up, so I can't say for sure. Maybe I should say more accurately. I've never been drugged, laid out, dragged into a dungeon, tied up, and so on. So, you know, I might not be the best judge of character on this one. Are you going to kill me? Where are we? Relax, sweetie pie. I'm making sure you're safe. Safe from what? Safe from the clutches of the ladies who try to steal you from me. Great. Isn't this a little extreme? You haven't seen anything yet. Oh, yeah, that's not foreboding. I'm prepared to go all out. I will do anything to protect my man. If you think anyone can stop me.
I think that's the first jump scare that's got me in this one. Hello? Breaking news, Apsir Inc. attacked by UFO. Well, that's one funky looking TV. Oh, I get it. This is the TV and this is a stand. Okay. Makes a little more sense now. How did I get home? Was I dreaming all along? I'd be saying, what the hell's going on with the news?
Little bro, thank God you're safe.
Dungeon.
That's the first thing you expect to hear from someone when you react like that to them.
Dungeon? The Apsir building exploded just an hour ago. It was all over the news. I was so worried.
No.
When I heard the news, I just had to go home. I've been calling you nonstop this afternoon.
Sorry.
Why doesn't your phone ring anymore? Now I had to cut my outgoing short.
My outside, jeez. So apparently she don't check his social media at all when he said he had to get a new phone. Great sister there.
He literally left a note on his social media, we'll assume Facebook, letting everyone know they had to change his number and stuff.
Whatever. I'm just glad you're okay. Don't scare me like that. Okay, bro?
Girlfriend.
Great. He's still just out of it.
A little off timing with the news there, baby bro. You have a girlfriend now? You? Wow, I've been gone a week.
You've been gone a week? That's my thoughts. I thought this was like day two.
Pictures. Okay, let me take a look. I didn't know you were the type to take selfies with his girlfriend. You hardly take pics of yourself. Besides, I'm sure she's ugly. But whatever, let me see. Wow, what a stone cold bee.
She's like, that's just mean. Straight up mean.
See? You're all alone in these pictures. Just you.
What?
There's no one else in here, brother. Please tell me you're joking. Please.
Oh no. Are you being serious right now?
No, that can't be right.
No.
Is everything fine? Oh my god, we have to see the doctor. Alright, brother, hang in there. I'm gonna look for the doc, take some medicine. We're gonna get through this. Everything's gonna be alright, baby bro. Your sister will make sure of it.
So I'm gonna point out one thing right here, and it's not just this game that's annoying me. Any, like, anime or anything like that. It's something that bugs me in general.
you, brothers and sisters don't go around calling themselves bro and sis all the time. It's just, it doesn't happen. And there's actually been a few animes that have made fun of that, believe it or not. It's just, yeah, it's very weird. It's not natural, in my opinion. If this has something to do with your brain tumor, we'll just make it go away again, okay? You have to be strong for me. You're the only family I have left. Doc will fix you up. I know he can. I'm sure he's here. Everything's gonna be alright, baby bro. Your sister will make sure of it. Once again, it's just, it's really off-putting because, like, typically, baby bro wouldn't have been said in this situation. And it, instead of your sister, people would typically say, like, I'll make sure of it. Or something along those lines. It's just, it's really off-putting. That's just my personal take on it, though. I've always been annoyed by that in anime and stuff, so it just seeing it so much here just triggering me a little bit, I'll admit. Just stay here for a while. I won't be gone long. If this is their apartment building, what are the odds the doctor's just hanging around there? Does he conveniently live in that same building? I have my doubts. Anything? Did I break the game? No, here we go. I like how the music picked up. I have to click to make it advance. Okay. She's getting a little too close without her eyes. Oh, there. Nope. She's almost there. That one didn't get me. There was too much lead up to it. Ha! Ah. Yes. Good work, Lilith. It seems the medicine worked exactly as we predicted it would. He's completely catatonic. Are you sure he's able to control the Trinemesis weapon? He already did. That attack on Apsura went exactly as planned. Well, actually, the performance exceeded our expectations. Gotta hand it to you, Doc. You did yourself when you revived the MK Ultra program. No, this isn't MK Ultra. This is far more superior. Yeah? The first iteration of MK Ultra was a failure compared to what we've achieved. This man in front of you is a scientific marvel.
What would happen if word got out?
Nothing. People who spread such news would be painted as conspiracy theorists. And besides, when legitimate files of MK Ultra were released to the public, did you see any mass protests? Any violent uprisings?
It's awful. I can't get my words out today worth crap.
Anyone can do an internet search of MK Ultra.
Which was a very good game, by the way. Actually, it was MK Ultimate, the same diff. That's what that was reminding me of, Mortal Kombat.
And the other former mind-splitting programs. And yet, they didn't stop us.
And I noticed, compared to the last video, from last video to this one, my voice has drastically changed for him. Just now realizing that. He's got like a deep brooding voice. Compared to whatever the hell I was using before, I don't even remember.
No worries then.
Transferring Kara Gentner's consciousness into his brain was quite the task. But it was all worth it in the end.
Okay. Why'd you pick Kara anyway?
Sentimental reasons. She was the last manufactured product of the Yandere experiments before we terminated the division. Her ruthless desire would augment the capabilities of the Trinemesis, but I must admit, I find it funny that this man here was falling for her.
Haha, great. It almost feels like her killing him and stuff. Maybe her way of stopping all this. We'll see if that's where this goes. This is the last chapter, unless there's a secret one.
Did he really think she was real? How desperate. He basically fell in love with his alter.
Well, not really. Not if she was literally implemented in his brain. I mean, that's a completely different entity. Not like he's fallen in love with an alter ego. This was literally a different person.
Now, don't be mean. He couldn't discern what was real and what was not. What's the difference between reality and imagination anyway?
Reality. Me hitting a wall. In my mind. Imaginary. There's a clear clue of difference.
Yeah, I know about the brain hallucinating conscious reality theories, but still, what a weirdo.
That car's consciousness is as real as ours, Lilith. A complete duplicate of the real car Gettner. I don't know why Gettner always comes out so hard for me. Always comes out as Gettner.
I don't know why I kept in that voice for that either.
With this man serving as the vessel, she will be able to use the Tri-Nemesis weapon with ease.
What if Kara rebels like the other one?
She is programmed in such a way that any insubordination will cause her to delete herself.
Oh, really?
Thanks, Doc. Shall we begin preparations?
9 damn times to get that line out! Because shall we kept coming out as shawoo, shawoo, shawoo. Tired brain, tired mouth does not work so well. Very frustrating.
Yes, the end of the world is upon us. Rejoice!
No, don't rejoice.
Oh, that thing. That's a funky looking thing.
Actually, I don't know what it reminds me of. I had to press the button again.
That was merely a demonstration of the Tri-Nemesis.
It looks more like a creature than a machine. I'm assuming it's a machine, since it's being controlled with mind and whatnot.
Soon, a new world will arise, and we will be its creators.
Why are so many evils bent on world destruction? It just makes no sense. What can you rule over when there's nothing left to rule? That's the paradox in all this. And here we are back in our mind, I guess.
Let your mind stay at our cake shop, my love. It will be over soon. Kara, this is not what I want. I have friends. I have dreams. Why can't I be enough? Why do you insist on living in a world of pain and suffering when you can have anything here?
Because this isn't real, Kara. You're not real. None of this is.
Don't say that. It's hurting me.
I hate you.
But...
We both know what this is about. You want me to be alone with you forever. You are selfish. That's all you are.
I know my glitchy nature freaks you out. And you hate that I kill people. But please, cut me some slack.
Yeah, you hate that I kill people. I don't know too many people that's gonna like that.
Cut me some slack? You know, I murder a few people. It's no big deal. It's nothing. Just don't worry about it. Just brush it off to the side.
That's just wrong on so many levels.
I did everything I could so we could be together. Because that's all I can ever have. What would have happened if you had fallen for Mia or anyone else? I'm not as pretty as other girls. Life would have been meaningless. You're literally the only person in my world. You're all the friend I'll ever have and all I'll ever need. Kara, I just wanted to have you. I want to thank you for all the times you made me happy. It's too bad I couldn't do much in return.
You know, it's funny. And yeah, this is going to end up causing a jump cut afterwards because I need to get a drink. But I'm having a considerably easier time reading Kara's and our line compared to Stuffy McButtstein there, Mr. Rot. I think a lot of it is, this feels more natural. I don't know if that's it or not, but maybe it's because it has more emotion to it.
And I don't have to talk like this.
Who knows? Who knows?
I just want a papyrus-like character to show up in one of these games so I can use my damn papyrus voice. I know, that'd be hard. Because there's only one papyrus. And yeah, I don't know if I'd pick up on it to do the papyrus voice. As you guys know, I've mentioned it in many videos. Out of all the voices or tones I do, papyrus, by far my favorite. In any case, this isn't Undertale, although a crossover would be pretty cool. Let's continue on.
I want to thank you for all the times you made me happy. It's too bad I couldn't do much in return. I wish I was able to cross into the real world and make you truly happy, but I can't. I'm sorry. If I truly love you, I won't force you to stay here. I'll let you be. Promise me you'll find the real Kara for me, okay? Please take care of her. This is where we say goodbye. I don't belong in your world, my love. This is where I belong.
Now, Tri-Nemesis, show your true power.
No.
Impossible. How are you still speaking?
I'll take it from here, love.
Obviously, I can't do two voices, so bear with me on this.
What the hell? How did you sound like Kara?
Great question, because vocal cords only have a certain amount of range. The fact that she can manipulate them to sound like her?
Amazing.
I won't let you in this world.
Impossible. Kara, don't you dare. If you continue your insubordination, you will die.
I'm prepared for that. I've already had my happy ending.
No!
Oh, I guess she's using that to blow them up, huh? So dumb.
I guess this is it. Farewell, my love.
Kara! I know, didn't even come close to saying that right, but...
It took some time for me to grasp what took place that night. The media reported the incident as a nuclear power plant disaster.
Okay, so I'm guessing with that, there had to be a nuclear power plant in this vicinity. And, which, by the way, seems very unlikely considering this looks like a very residential business type area. Nuclear plants aren't typically around places where there's vast amount of people because of the radiation that literally seeps out of them. If you, like, I don't have any near where I live, but I've known people that have lived near them. Well, spoke to them online, the easier way to say. I don't know them on a person-to-person basis, but... apparently, extremely affordable to live next to a nuclear power plant because it's so unhealthy for you, so bad for you. It is life-shortening bad. So yeah, don't think there'd be one of those in an area like this with a bunch of tall buildings, office buildings, and whatnot. It's not feasible. And the fact that the public believe that, does that mean, one, the improbable that there was one there, and they had to go out of their way to destroy it to actually make it seem like this could be the case? Just, it's a lot to buy. This is where conspiracy theories are born from, people. Just, it doesn't add up. It really doesn't. In any case... Unfortunately, the public believed the sinister cover-up. From that night on, I spent every day researching the truth of what happened that night. I couldn't find any solid proof, and eventually, I gave up. Great way to help Kara there. You just gave up on it. Great. Every year, I'd always find time to sneak into the restricted areas of city ruins to pay my respects. I prayed for my sister and for Kara. I'm wondering at this point if his sister is actually real, really his sister or not. You wouldn't think his sister would be so willing for all this, unless she was just that crap crazy. I often wonder if the Kara inside my head had a soul, and every time I do, I feel a cold breeze. I eventually become Absurding's graphic design consultant. Despite the busy schedule, I ensured that I had enough time for my promise. I promised to find the real Kara Gintner. Eventually, I received a tip from a private investigator I knew. Kara once said it would be nice if I could take care of the real Kara. Well, I wondered if the real Kara would want that. True ending. Well, at least we didn't die this time. Created by Darius Emmanuel Guerrero. Voiced by Amber Lee Connors. Music by Alkanite? I don't know. Feel free to check these links out if you want to, guys. Ha! Chilling. Oh, there's more stuff. Okay. Gotta say, I was not expecting that. But that almost looks like his sister, but we don't get a real... Nope, that's him. Oh, God! I thought it was his sister. Ha, ha, ha! I guess maybe they could have been related. At least the mustache and beard look better grown out. Compared to that little... pinstripe mustache? I don't know what it's called. The Zorro mustache. That's what I see it as, because that's what I always saw. Like, that's the only one I ever saw. I don't know what I want to say. I'm tired. In any case, let's continue on, since this isn't over yet. Kara, is it really you?
Coming March 29th, 2018.
We're a little past that date. I should be doing it this way so you can hear it a little better.
The Last Yandere. Thank you for playing The Last Yandere. If you liked it, please try its sequel, Dear.exe. And that is the next game we'll be going through, guys. And if I'm not mistaken, there's Dear.exe, the first fright or something like that it's called. It was DLC that came with DearEvil.exe. I see words. Remove ads and yes. okay. But I think the first fear is Dear.exe. I'm going to double check that, and I know it's Dare as in Yandere, but like that, I can't help but read it as Deer. And I know D-E-E-R is Deer, not D-E-R-E is Dare. Dury. Deary. There's no winning with it. But yeah, that'll be our next one to go through, and I'm hoping, since I know it's a platforming type game like DearEvil.exe, I'm hoping I'll be able to get through it, because I think this one may be harder than the second one was, going by what the game was saying anyway. Actually, from what I've read in... Where was I read that? Maybe on Steam? I read that it was hard there too, but they also said DearEvil.exe was extremely hard, and that wasn't too bad. It was doable for me, so if it's doable for me, say okay. In any case, that's where we're ending things, guys. That's where we're ending things. Each one of these come out to about half an hour by the time we get stuff cut out. About 20 to 25 minutes. That's pretty good. So, yeah, if you haven't enjoyed this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. I really appreciate that. If you want to, you can follow me on Twitter at KirkyEV. Subscribe here on YouTube. Hit that little notification bell. Be part of the notification squad. Make sure it's like to always be notified. Be notified of my daily upcoming content. You can also catch me over on Top Buzz and Instagram. All those links and more, as always, description down below. Now, what I think of this game? I liked it. I can say that. There was, and I pointed it out while playing, the whole big bro, little bro, big sis thing just kind of threw me off, because it's just a personal pet peeve I have from anime in general, because people don't talk like that. But this was holding in with the anime trope like that, so it makes sense in this situation. Even if it does make me want to just, you know, eye twitch just a little bit. Oh man, that makes my eye itch. But yeah, I like the game quite a bit. Looking forward to the next one. I almost feel like starting that right away, but I've got like 18 Mega Man Maker stages I gotta get through. You guys are not letting me get that list whittled down at all. I even made a video that was 7 freaking stages long, and that put me from 20 down to freaking 12 or 13. Now I'm back up there to 18. You won't let me get the list down, guys. You gotta give me a little break. And they have to just straight up say, I need a little time to get through my current list before you start sending in more. This might be the only solution here. If it ever gets to the point that there's too many, I don't know what I'm going to do. Because I'd like to try to play all of your stages if I can. But I know if the channel grows up big enough that I can't, I don't know. I just have to say one stage per. And if I miss it, I miss it. I don't know. In any case, look forward to the next game in this series, Dear.exe. I'm going to create the shortcut and stuff to it, because this one is a DLC. It's hidden in the main game files, which is really weird to me. But at the same time, I'm not going to complain about it. So yeah, I'm going to end things here. I do want to try to get a Mega Man Maker, or maybe two, recorded today. Probably just the one, because I'm tired. And I really just want to sleep. My head hurts. But yeah, we're ending things here. So, see you later, guys. Guys, my new YouTube pals, Ivan Kirkyhee. But of course, I'm always Kirkyhee. Haha, see you guys in the next video.